Friday films, it's always good to have a few good options. We have Patrick Beatty to talk about some scary movies this
yes.
week. Are you a big, like, scary thriller movie fan?
It just seems to become, it's hitting us. We just keep getting these zombie movies. We're getting these scary
movies.
You know,
we lived through a pandemic, so why not make it scarier?
Why not, right? They're doing pandemic movies now because why not? Let's keep you in there.
Okay, so Army of the Dead is the first one. It is
yes.
a thriller.
Yes, so this is coming from Netflix. This is a Zack Snyder zombie film. So if you saw the Dawn of the Dead remake, he directed that. He directed the Man of Steel trilogy. And he's basically returning to form in this with his zombie film.
Okay, should we take a clip?
Let's take a look.
There's $200 million in the vault beneath the strip. With a 32-hour window to get it out. Find the safe. This should be a simple in and out.
Oh, this is fun and
so much fun. It's a heist film. This is Ocean's 11 meets a zombie movie.
I love this.
Las Vegas is all quarantined off because there's a zombie outbreak there. They've sequestered everybody. However, there's a plan to go and take some money that's already been claimed by insurance from a vault, get out before they nuke the entire city,
okay.
and hopefully the biggest heist can go off. But there are some zombies that are crazy in this.
Oh, so definitely the older kids, adults.
Yes, so this is an R-rated film.
R,
it's
okay.
in theaters, and I would check it out in theaters, too.
Because it's that good. Did you like it? What's your rating?
For me, I gave it a 7.5 out of 10. Zack Snyder films, hit or miss for me, but visually, this worked really well. And
okay, that's
fun.
A pretty high mark.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the next one, it's
yes.
called The Woman in the Window. Again, R-rated. Mm-hmm. Tell me about this one.
We have a little bit of an Alfred Hitchcock vibe, something to the effect of Rear Window, but we have a clip for that, too.
Okay, let's take a listen.
This is a safe place. I'm agoraphobic. Can't go inside. I've been slipping, getting into a really dark frame of mind.
If you're looking for some type of mystery where you're looking for kind of a whodunit in the vein of an Alfred Hitchcock type film, this is the movie for you. Amy Adams is the lead. She has agoraphobia. She will not leave her house, but she sees across the way something happening at another neighbor's house that causes her to try to reach out to police, see if there's some type of thing that's happening, and whether it's in her head or not, you don't know.
Okay, so Amy Adams, what do you think? This is kind of a little bit different from her regular genres.
Yes, she's very good, though, in every role that she's taken. Like, I love Amy Adams in everything.
Yeah, she's
and
good.
She does incredible in this. All the supporting cast, Gary Oldman's in it. They all are kind of in it sporadically, but not a lot. I wish I saw more people in it than Amy Adams. However, she is the star of the show and does great.
Okay, and Alfred Hitchcock. I mean, it's hard to compare,
yes.
but how would you rate this one?
You know, you can't really give it the same rating, obviously, so
no.
I'm going a 7 out of 10 for this, but definitely check it out. I think it's worth it if you love Hitchcock movies, for sure.
All right, the last one. Let's take a peek and a clip at this one.
Jigsaw? Wait, I thought the Jigsaw killer was dead.
He is.
Okay, this is not for the faint of heart here. And who am I looking at? Jigsaw?
Hello there.
Oh, Jigsaw, hello.
Thank you for letting me to come here, have this time. I go by Brian, actually, for this. That's more my stage name, but I'm excited to be here to talk about my new movie because, honestly, 2020 has been rough for everybody.
Okay, you're kind of freaking me out here.
I know, but here's the thing. We've had 8 movies of these soft films, and finally, we get a chance to change. And 2020, it changed me, and I'm having a glow up in 2021. This is
I can tell this is the glow up. Samuel L. Jackson in this movie. How did you like playing against him?
Samuel Jackson, Chris Rock, they came in and they took this franchise and changed it for the better. I love the style. I love where they're going. I'm not featured in it too much, but that's okay. Like, I'll just, the spirals are there, and that's good enough for me.
Okay, excellent. Okay. Well, Patrick, thank you so much. How would you rate this one?
I'd give it a 6 out of 10.
Patrick, how do we find you? You do all the movie reviews right there on Instagram and Twitter, social media platforms.
Yes, Patrick Bader Reviews, Gaggle of Geeks, all that good stuff.
All right, thank you, Patrick.
Thank you.
All right, coming up next, we have Cards and Coffee just opened up downtown in Salt Lake with a wide array of collector items to check out. Thank you.